kinder. We know you'll find we're a one of a kinder. Now that you're here, it's time to unwind, for you can let yourself be part of our family. There's gonna be some great times tonight, and soon you'll see that we treat you quite right. So grab some food, we'll put you in the mood.
Welcome once again to the fabulous Organ Grinder restaurant located in Toronto, Canada. This is Memories of the Organ Grinder, and I'm your host, Jeanne Beker. During our show, we'll be taking you and your family on a bit of a musical adventure, an up-close look at one of the world's most exciting restaurants, a truly unique place, a real one-of-a-kinder. A piece of history is recreated here with a stunning array of musical gadgets collected over time from parts far and wide, and today not found anywhere else the world over. There is much more to the Organ Grinder than what you see around me here tonight. Behind the scenes is where a lot of the action takes place. So let's begin with a brief bit of history, and then let's have a look. Life was much simpler in the early days of popular entertainment, but by no means was it dull. As exciting and interesting as, say, modern jazz or pop music is to us today, so was theater pipe organ music in the early 1900s, and particularly the mighty Wurlitzer pipe organ. This huge incarnation was invented around 1920, and musically, this instrument fast became all the rage for the exuberant and brilliant sound and the mastery of the musicians who played them. People filled the music halls and theaters to experience this new and exciting sound. The mighty Wurlitzer, a fire-breathing musical monster as powerful and dynamic as a modern rock band, opened new doors to not only the music listening experience, but also gave a new dimension and meaning to otherwise silent movies. Silent filmmaking, in need of an added element of excitement, soon became the recognized medium of theater pipe organ music. Yes, those days may seem simple by comparison to music of the 90s, yet still today many of us remember those icons of the Hollywood silent film era. The great romantics Valentino, Mary Pickford, Douglas Fairbanks, and of course, who doesn't know of or remember the wonderfully funny and timeless antics of Charlie Chaplin? In the early but then modern 1900s, theater pipe organ music was as big a hit as the screen stars. I'm accompanied by a rather extraordinary fellow, Don Malcolm. He's the organist here at the Organ Grinder and the focus of entertainment. Hi, Don.
Hi, Jeanne.
Thanks so much for taking time out to talk with us tonight. I know you've been having an awful lot of fun up there.
Well, like any other entertainer, though, I need a bit of a break from time to time, especially after playing the mighty Wurlitzer. You know, it's a lot to handle. But I got to admit that deep down, I'm a really lucky guy because I really enjoy what I do, and how many other people can enjoy their work so much and also get paid for it.
Don, you've won numerous competitions. You also teach electronic organ music, and you've hosted a couple of festivals.
Well, actually, that's right, Jeanne, as well. I won the one at the Yamaha Canadian National Organ Festival, which they held every year now, and I won about three times in that. I've hosted a couple of those festivals as well. And, you know, again, teaching is all part of bringing people into the world of music as well.
And you started playing organ here at the age of 14. That's incredible.
That's correct, and I'm 24 now, so it's been just about 10 years, and I've really developed a special place in my heart for the mighty Wurlitzer.
Well, earlier today you introduced me to all the interesting adaptations of instruments and other fine details that go into the creation and playing of this huge pipe organ. Why don't we go back a bit and share with our audience what's behind the scenes?
Since the time that I've been here, again, I started here when I was 14, so it's basically 10 years now. And I would have to say that over the amount of time, it's gone from being a place where I maybe just came to work to a place where it's truly part of me and I have a lot of fun playing here. And again, when people show up and come in, they can forget about whatever's happened to them during the day.
Good stuff. Don, I am very impressed by the amazing array of instruments that you have around here.
Well, yes, Jeanne, it's quite an amazing setup in itself. Again, the Organ Grinder and this type of restaurant was very popular over the years from the 70s on. But this kind of concept, and theater organs were, of course, been around for many years. This particular instrument's from 1929. The concept of the organ grinder, though, and this type of establishment with pizza and pipes and whatever that we have here, this was actually originally pioneered in the United States. And there was originally about 30 organ grinder type restaurants in the States. The organ grinder in Canada was originally brought here in 1975, and we also had another one in Vancouver. That one's no longer present, but the organ grinder in Toronto is probably one of the most popular organ grinder type restaurants in the world. We get people here from all over, from Australia, from Germany, wherever, and they've all heard of the organ grinder and come in here to see this amazing instrument, because there's so much different instruments and different things that there is for them to enjoy when they come here.
If you walked in here for the first time in the middle of the organist's performance, you would likely be quite overwhelmed with the sheer brilliance of the theater pipe organ and all the sounds. The submarine and police sirens, sleigh bells, all kinds of chimes and drums, all activated from the main organ. This really is a lot of fun for kids of all ages. Just look around. People love it here.
Don, not one of these instruments, or any of the components of the organ for that matter, has been automated or computerized in any way. And I understand that the organ is just as it was back in 1929.
That's correct, Jeanie. Actually, even this player piano here is driven by air. And everything, all of the instruments around the room are both driven by air power alone. No electrical means, and there's no automation at all. Everything's done manually by the organist.
This is really bizarre, Don. I guess you'd call this the heart and soul of the organ.
Well, that it is, Jeanie. This is the chamber room behind the organ, and this is where the majority of the pipes are. Again, there's over 1,000 pipes on the instrument, and they're made of all different materials, like wood, as you can see here, tin, zinc, lead, and whatever else. And this is, as I say, where the main body of the sound comes from for the true theater organ sound. In fact, I'll just give you a little sample of one of those notes right now. This is a trumpet pipe, and this is the one of the C notes. You can see how it's tuned here and whatever else, but I'll just let you hear exactly what a car horn would be like, I guess.
Oh, great!
Along this wall over here, Jeanie, and over here as well, we have the tibia pipes. Now, again, this is just an extension of some of the other pipes that I showed you earlier in the chamber room. These are, again, all made out of wood and air-driven, and I'll give you a sample of what one of these would sound like.
That's fun. Now, this is a very strange-looking instrument. What's that?
Yeah, this is the Glockenspiel. Now, this is another percussion instrument, and it gives you a very high, crisp, bell-like kind of sound. And what that does is it cuts through a lot of the murk associated with some of the lower pipes and that kind of thing to, you know, again, bring out the melody better.
And Don, tell me about these. I've never seen anything like that before.
Those are regulators. What they do is they just make sure that the amount of air, the airflow that goes into the pipes and the other instruments is constant and it doesn't overblow or whatever else.
Mm-hmm. Now, that looks mildly familiar because that looks like sleigh bells.
And it is. Those are tuned sleigh bells, actually. So there's 25 notes up there. What those give you is, again, the sound of a sleigh bell, but you can actually hear individual notes.
Now, Don, what's so special about this upright piano here?
Well, it's not a typical Yamaha or Steinway upright piano, actually. It's a player piano. So what we've done is converted this. You can see right along here the action. And what we've done is converted it to play with the theater organ. So when I'm up there and I select the piano sound, what'll happen is it'll actually start playing the keys, just as if I was actually sitting right at the keyboard.
Amazing.
Now over here, we have the marimba. Now this is a malleted instrument. As you can see, there's wood blocks up here. And again, what happens is the mallets hit the blocks and it produces a sound, but that's all activated from the keyboard.
And you've got a cymbal over there?
Yeah, that's similar to a, say, an open hi-hat kind of effect on a drum kit.
And sleigh bells above.
Which are very useful for Christmas kind of music.
An impressive big drum there.
Yeah, that's a bass drum again, and it's activated two different ways. We have a bass drum hit, which is a very boomy kind of sound, similar to a concert bass drum. Also a kettle drum, doesn't boil water, but what it does is it'll play the mallets real quick and you get this very timpani kind of effect. Behind that, the crash cymbal as well, which is, again, a really loud cymbal used primarily, I guess, at the end of songs or, you know, 1812 overture or something like that.
Why don't you do your stuff and show us how some of these jive together?
Sounds like a great idea.
Okay.
Don really knows how to get the audience here involved, and there's a certain feeling that takes over after a while. Our customers just kind of let go and have some real old-fashioned fun. Parents don't have to worry about the kids' behavior in the organ grinder either. This place was designed for kids. As said before, of all ages. People keep returning year after year, sometimes even week after week. I'm sure it's because of the atmosphere, the easygoing style we provide, the kind of attention we pay to the customer. The staff all have as much fun as the customer does, only we have our fun, enjoy our jobs more, and make sure that the customer thoroughly enjoy themselves, day after day.
And it gets even more complicated than that.
Oh, yeah. Well, there's all sorts of other instruments that you can add on as well. And if you want, well, basically, you ain't seen nothing yet.
Oh, all right. Let's go for it.
Well, Jeanne, so far you've seen a fair amount of different effects and sounds on the organ. And as I was saying before, there's over 1,000 pipes on them. You've seen a lot of them. Different sound effects. 13, actually. Most of them are right up here. And also 10 different drum effects, plus all sorts of other instruments. Here's another example. The tubular bells right up here. And what I'm going to do right now is let you hear what everything sounds like when it's being played at the same time.
Okay, I can't wait.
Here we go. Well, so far you've heard just about everything, but as I was showing you over there, we're going to increase the amount of volume and instruments that you're going to hear right now. I'm going to demonstrate a little song that'll show you what everything else sounds like when it's all going at the same time. You can already hear that it's revving up, and we're going to do something that features clarinets up here on the cymbals. And here we go.
And now I know why everyone who comes to the organ grinder has so much fun. What a marvelous place. 50 different pipe organs, 25 different musical gadgets, sleigh bells, drums, police and submarine sirens, chimes, 1,000 theater organ pipes, and 292 tuned percussion notes on the many various instruments. Great food, great fun for the entire family, and of course, great free entertainment. We all hope that you've enjoyed Memories of the Organ Grinder as much as I have, and we hope that you'll come again to this wonderful and unique musical pizza eatery, the Organ Grinder. See you again soon.
Do you go?